What's up, icons? It's the iconic fashion figure. In the last 2 weeks, y'all haven't gotten to see my face, but I'm back. In those videos, I spend time talking about different website builders, as a few of you requested already, want to know where to build your website at. So you've gotten these different style videos that I've never done before, just showing you my screen of different website builders you can choose from. Showed you 10 of them. And I'm sure the way that those videos were done, and because I went through them so fast, it may not all have made sense to you guys. So I wanted to do a recap and just give my opinion on a few of the different website builders and recommend the ones that I think would be best, especially for beginners. So for all the new people to my channel, welcome. For those of you that are returning, I appreciate you guys and welcome back. But let's get right into the video. Okay, so jumping right into the video. I may look up and down quite a bit because I have all the notes on my phone, so I can just get right through it. So there were 10 website builders that I've shown you guys in the last two videos. If you haven't checked those videos out, you can either pause this video and go watch those and then come back to this one, or you can watch this one and then go back to those videos to see what the hell it is that I'm talking about. So basically, I just did kind of like a rating for the different website builders that I talked about, and then rated them on like the best options for certain categories. So I'm just gonna go through a few of those categories and give my reason why. So the one that I said that has the most features is WordPress.org, which is in the first video. And the reason I say that is because there's so many plugins available for WordPress. It's like the options are endless. So there's so much you can do with the WordPress.org. Remember, there's two WordPress options. WordPress.org is the one that you have endless opportunities when it comes to being creative for your website. So if you're looking for one that has a lot of features and a lot of functionality, WordPress.org would be the go-to. So the one category that everyone's probably waiting for is as far as pricing, which one's the cheapest. And the cheapest one, I kind of weighed this in two different ways. So the cheapest you can get is SquareUp.com, because there is the free option. But you have to keep in mind, you can't connect a custom domain there. It's gonna be like your store's name.squareup.com or whatever it is, or something like that. So it won't be your own domain, but you can still create an online store for free through SquareUp. Now, if you want like a true online store that is your own with your own domain, you can either continue with SquareUp or you can go Weebly, because both of them were $12 a month. So SquareUp and Weebly kind of tied for that category if we're talking about a true online store with your own domain. Otherwise, SquareUp won it if we're talking about completely free, regardless of what features you get. Now, one category that most beginners may not think about, because as a beginner, this is probably the last thing on your mind, is analyzing your website. But I will tell you guys, this business, even though you want to get creative, you need to know your customer, you want to solve everyone's needs, especially since there's a lot of competition in this business, and you want to offer the right products and the right service. At the end of the day, this business is a numbers game. It's all about the numbers. And I'm not talking about just money, because yeah, we all want to make a profit. That's the end goal. But this business is about numbers in order to even get to a profit. And what I mean by that is you have to analyze everything that goes on with your business, from the customers to the traffic on your website, to your sales, to your returns, to decline rates, to increase rates. Like, you're looking at all the different numbers when it comes to your business. There's so much to look at there. I literally analyze my business on a daily basis, and then I do a weekly and monthly. And then I do from year to date, and then like looking at what the previous year, things like that. So it's all about the numbers. So you definitely want a website where you can analyze everything. So I created a category for that, to let you guys know what the best website is for analyzing and that's Shopify, because they generate the reports for you. You're gonna pay money for it, but you'll have all the answers there, and if you truly analyze your business, you should be able to make up that money that you're spending on the Shopify website. Now, a lot of you will probably say to me, well, why don't you have Shopify? If you analyze your business so much, why wouldn't you use Shopify? Well, one, because Shopify, they do have a lot of the features that I need, but I have to pay it way a lot more than what I'm paying. Plus, since I use WordPress.org, if you guys don't already know, if you didn't see it from the other videos, there's so many plugins with WordPress.org where I can still download things and analyze it. I just have to put in a little more work. It's not auto-generated for me like it is with Shopify. But Shopify is the best when it comes to analyzing because they have the best reports out there. Okay, the next one, as far as ease of use. I believe the easiest one to use, they're all pretty easy because most of them are drag and drop websites, but the easiest is Wix.com. And the reason I say that is because they have that feature where they can just ask you a few questions about your business, you answer it, and it auto-generates a website for you. There's a name for the feature, I keep just saying it's the auto creator. I can't think of what the name is, I can look it up, but I showed it to you guys in the other videos. That one's in the first video. But I would say that's the easiest to use because you literally answer five questions and they create a website for you. Okay, this is another good category where it may help you guys out a lot because there are so many different options for it. So I created a category for best themes. And this one was tough for me to do because it all depends on your personal preference and how you want your website to look. I just made an overall choice of what caught my eye the quickest. So for best themes, I chose Squarespace. If you guys have watched the video, it's the second part. You've seen how I was as soon as I got on the Squarespace website. So that's why I chose Squarespace for the best themes. They all have a ton of them. Some of them you have to pay for, like I know with WordPress.org, some of them I had to pay for if I wanted to use them, but I chose a free one. And then Shopify, there was a lot of them you had to pay for and they were expensive. But of the other ones where the themes were free, I think Squarespace had the best ones. Oh, and just so you guys know, because after doing all this research for you guys and pulling all this information together, I keep getting all these ads that pop up on all my social medias. Every time I Google something, things popping up on my phone, all these different ads because, you know, government's stalking us and everything we do. Probably listen to my video right now and stalking me. I'm going to start getting a bunch more ads. But I found another option. And this one seemed pretty neat, which is the only reason why I've thrown this in here. So now you guys got 11 options. And it was called, I hope I'm spelling it correct, I'll put it on the screen. It's called Ecwid, E-C-W-I-D. I'm hoping I'm pronouncing that right. But the reason that one caught my eye is because of the Facebook and Instagram integration. They claim that they make it a lot easier for you to integrate your website with Facebook and Instagram. And the reason I feel that is a good feature is because of with Instagram, you have the shoppable feature where you can tag your products and your posts and in your stories. So for those of you that are beginners and you need free marketing, social media is the way to go. And you'll want to be able to tag your product so it can redirect your customer to your website. Now I can tell you from personal experience, if you guys go on my business Instagram, I'm not tagging my products yet because I'm still trying to get Instagram to approve it because you have to be approved for it. And it gets rejected, and then it's like this whole chaos of trying to actually get it to be accepted. But once I saw that, I was like, oh, that's a good one that I should let you guys know, because if it's that easy with Ecwid or whatever the heck this website builder is called, that'll be a way to go because that saves you on marketing. But back into my categories. So we're pretty much wrapping this video up now at this point. The website builder that I would recommend for beginners, especially those of you that are on a budget. And the reason I say this is because in the beginning, you want to save as much money as possible and put in as little bit of your own money as possible when starting it. So I went with SquareUp.com. And the reason I say that, two reasons. One, you can start it out free, and that's saving you money to get started, which means you can spend more money on your products. Two, SquareUp connects directly to your little Square card reader, and it updates your inventory whether you sell online or in person. And I can tell you, when I did the whole boutique phase, and I was selling, I would sell anywhere. There was a point where I was moving from New York to Florida, and I had all my products in my trunk, and I would be wearing things, like when I would go out and about, like in a mall, going to the grocery store. When people asked me about my outfit and what I was wearing, I would give them my card, and I would let them know I had the products right then and there, so if they wanted to buy it, I have it. I can get it for you out the car and pack it up for you. You can use a Square reader to sell your item, and then it gets removed from your inventory, so that way if someone's shopping on your website, it'll show that that size is now gone or sold out, whatever the case is. As a beginner, you gotta hustle any and every way that you can to get your business name out there, so that way you can make your money. So that's the reason I recommend SquareUp. Now, as for me, with my website and my personal preference on a website, I'm recommending SquareUp to all beginners, but for me, I will still stick with my WordPress.org website, and the reason being is there's so many different things I can do with my website. Like the website that I built from the very beginning up until now is completely different because I keep adding things and changing things. The more and more that I learn about WordPress.org, I make those updates. And just like you guys are sitting here watching my video trying to learn about website builders, I was once in your shoes on YouTube searching website builders. And then once I decided to go with WordPress.org, I was then on YouTube trying to learn how to build that website since I had to do it all myself. So since I've already invested so much time in WordPress.org and I can get everything that I need out of WordPress.org and it's been so cheap for me, I'm sticking with WordPress.org. So for those of you that start out with Squarespace in the beginning just to get things going, maybe you'll switch to WordPress.org like where I am now. Who knows? But those are pretty much all the categories as far as the different website builders. Trying to give you guys as much information as I can so that way I can help you guys out with getting your business going. Of course, if you have any other questions or anything else you want to know about websites or anything that has to do with business, leave it down in the comments because I try to read every single one. I'll do whatever I can to create the video for you guys. Like, I know the next thing that's been requested is about my photo shoots and how I do it. Like I just told you, I just finished doing a photo shoot for this outfit and some other outfits, and I literally do them right in my home. So I'll definitely show you guys exactly how I do it, how easy and cheap it is for me to take those pictures of my products for my website. So until next week, thank you guys for watching.